Everyone, myself Nagaraj Koppa, working as an assistant professor in the Department of Civil Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In the present video lecture, I am going to deliver content related to methods of bearing capacity of soil. So these are the learning outcomes from the video. At the end of this session, student will be able to explain about different methods to determine bearing capacity of soil as well as explain about assumptions of Terzaghi's bearing capacity theory. So these are the contents present in the video lecture. So in the previous video lecture, I have already explained about definition of bearing capacity, basic terminologies related to bearing capacity, modes of failure in the footing section. In the present video lecture, it is methods to determine bearing capacity. So there are totally four methods to determine SBC of soil sample. In the four method, first method is analytical method, second one plate bearing test, third one penetration test, fourth one laboratory test. So first method is analytical method. In the analytical method, there are once again five methods to determine SVC of soil. First method is Terzaghi's bearing capacity, second one Meyerhoff's equation, third one Wessick's equation, fourth one IS method, last one Tank's equation. So second method is plate bearing test. By using plate load apparatus, we are going to calculate SVC of soil sample. It means by applying vertical pressure on the soil sample, it means by using load versus settlement curve, we are going to calculate ultimate bearing capacity of soil as well as settlement of structure. Penetration test, once again there are two methods to determine SBC of soil. One is SPT test and one more DCPT test. SPT, standard penetration test, DCPT, Dutch cone penetration test. By using N value, by using number of impact action, N value, number of blows, we are going to calculate SBC of soil sample. Here, this person is applying impact force on the vertical rod. It means this vertical rod, it may penetrate up to 15 centimeter for the first extent, for second extent, once again 15 centimeter, for third extent, once again up to 15 centimeter. For the 15 centimeter penetration, what is the amount of N value? By using that N value, we are going to calculate this SBC of soil sample by using Tank's equation. Fourth method, laboratory test. By using shear parameters C and phi, we are going to calculate SBC of soil sample. In the first method, analytical method, so Terzaghi's bearing capacity theory. So Terzaghi, he has given some assumptions related to his theory. First assumption is soil is semi-infinite, homogeneous and isotropic in nature. From the figure, QU is nothing but vertical pressure which is coming from the superstructure. At the same point, once again, upward resistance force which is acting in upward direction. Due to the simultaneous action of QU in vertical direction, both upward as well as downward direction, what will happen? This sigma, that lateral force, it may induced inside the soil sample. I will talk about QU. This amount of stress QU which is offering by superstructure, it may go up to unlimited extent in the foundation soil. Even lateral force is also which is acting in unlimited extent, both x direction, left direction as well as right direction. But come back to upward resisting force which is acting only up to the ground level. Therefore, hence we are calling this term as semi-infinite. Homogeneous, homo is nothing but same, genius is nothing but pressure. So this bulb like structure, we are calling it as pressure bulb of soil sample. So this is the footing, so it is structure. So just below the footing, the properties of soil sample are same in the pressure bulb. Therefore, he assumed this term as homogeneous. Iso is nothing but once again same, tropic is nothing but a direction. Whatever the properties of soil sample as well as stress induced in the soil sample is same in both direction, x direction as well as y direction. Second assumption, base of footing is rough. This base of footing is, he assumed base of footing is a rough. The failure is by general shear failure. He assumed that failure is general shear failure. Basically, general, in the previous video lecture, I have already explained the term general shear failure. General shear failure occurs in stiff type of soil sample and hard type of soil sample, particularly friction angle greater than 36 degree. This general shear failure are occurring now. So this surface, it is nothing but a bulging plane. So this surface we are calling it as slip surface. Both bulging plane and slip surface, they are contacting at the ground level. Therefore, he assumed that general shear failure for his theory. Fourth assumption is load is vertical and symmetrical. So from this picture, QU is nothing but once again ultimate bearing capacity, so which is acting in downward direction at the same point at the bottom of footing. So resistant force is also acting. It means this amount of QU is equal to resisting force. Therefore, vertical, so stress induced inside the soil sample as well as stress at every point on the bottom of footing is equal. Therefore, he assumed that force is vertical and symmetrical. Fifth condition, the ground surface is horizontal. This ground surface is horizontal. Sixth one, the stress distributed is two-dimensional. So this stress distributed, whatever the stress distributed inside the soil sample is two-dimensional. It means due to the vertical pressure, sometime the horizontal pressure may also acting inside the soil. It is in lateral direction. Therefore, along x-axis and along y-axis, we are calling it as two-dimensional force. Seventh assumption, the overburden pressure at the footing level is equivalent to surcharge load. I will talk about this picture. So as usual, it is a footing which is carrying the load P1. So P2 is nothing but overburden pressure. At last, at the footing level, P is equal to P1 plus P2. Therefore, where P is nothing but ultimate bearing capacity, P2 is nothing but overburden pressure, P1 is nothing but net ultimate bearing capacity. Therefore, net ultimate bearing capacity equal to ultimate bearing capacity. So this ultimate bearing capacity minus gamma into DF, where gamma is nothing but unit weight of soil sample, DF is nothing but depth of footing. So eighth assumption, so Coulomb's law is strictly valid. So in the geotechnical one, already we have learnt about Mohr's Coulomb theory. So Mohr's Coulomb theory, in the Coulomb's theory, Coulomb's, he explained strength theory of soil sample. Mohr's, he explained stress theory of soil sample. By using semicircle and Coulomb's envelope, we are going to calculate C and phi. It means he assumed, he explained the things related to bearing capacity of theory based on Coulomb's law. Therefore, S equal to C plus sigma tan phi, where S is nothing but shear strength of soil, C is nothing but cohesion of soil, sigma is nothing but normal stress, phi is nothing but, once again, it is friction angle of soil sample. You may pause the video now and give the correct answers. So these are the correct answers. According to the assumptions in the Terzaghi's beam analysis, the stress is distributed in two-dimensional. According to the assumptions in Terzaghi's analysis, the soil is homogeneous and isotropic. So it is actually limitation of Terzaghi's bearing capacity theory. The soil sample is in heterogeneous and anisotropic in condition. So these are the references for this video lecture. Thank you.